A judge just set bail at $5 million for the man accused of killing 20-year-old Mollie Tibbetts as the case becomes a talking point in the immigration debate. Cristhian Rivera, an undocumented immigrant from Mexico, confessed to abducting the 20-year-old college student last month in Brooklyn, Iowa. After news of Rivera's arrest, President Trump quickly cited the case as an example of why tougher laws are needed to combat illegal immigration. CNN's Diane Gallagher joins me live in Montezuma, Iowa, where Rivera just appeared in court. And Diane, Rivera, he worked at a dairy farm owned in part by a prominent Iowa Republican. How was Rivera able to get through the screening process?
So, Jake, just in the past couple minutes here, we've gotten a little more clarification on this. The owner of that dairy farm coming out and saying basically he gave a different name. This is not the man that we thought he was. It's not the name on his paperwork. And they didn't use the DHS E-Verify system, instead using this older Social Security verification system. Now, still a lot of unanswered questions here. That isn't stopping the politicization of Mollie Tibbetts' death, something that people here in Iowa wish they wouldn't focus on right now.
The outcome no one wanted, but so many in this close Iowa community feared. The disappearance of Mollie Tibbetts, now a case of murder. 24-year-old Cristhian Bahena Rivera, an undocumented immigrant from Mexico, charged in the 20-year-old University of Iowa student's death this afternoon.
You have been charged with murder in the first degree.
After more than a month of searching, investigators say Bahena Rivera led them to a cornfield Tuesday, where they found a body believed to be Mollie Tibbetts.
He tells us that at some point in time he blacks out, and then he comes to near an intersection in which we believe he then placed Mollie.
Investigators say Bahena Rivera worked at Yarbee Farms, owned in part by Craig Lane, a prominent Iowa Republican. In a news conference this afternoon, the farm said it believed it was doing due diligence, but was using the wrong system.
What we learned in the last 24 hours is that our employee was not who he said he was. And just within the last 4 hours, we have come to learn that the Social Security Administration Employment Verification Service is not the same as E-Verify.
And within hours of the arrest, politicians began using Tibbetts' death as a rallying point for the right. Iowa's Republican senators released a joint statement blaming, quote, criminals who broke our immigration laws, adding, quote, we cannot allow these tragedies to continue. The president wading even further into politicizing her murder at a rally in West Virginia, blaming Democrats for weak border security.
And you saw what happened to that incredible, beautiful young woman. The immigration laws are such a disgrace. We're getting them changed, but we have to get more Republicans.
In a statement, the Tibbetts family thanked the nation for the love and support while asking for privacy as they grieve. Friends say they hope the politics now surrounding her death won't overshadow her life.
Do you fear that the whole illegal immigrant part of this conversation now will take over?
We all came from immigrants.
Yeah. But this isn't about being political.
No. This is about Mollie being a smart, beautiful,
very intelligent
young woman.
Now, people here in Iowa are going to be remembering her tonight. Mollie Tibbetts should have been starting her sophomore year of college at the University of Iowa. They're going to hold a vigil, Jake, in about 2 hours there on campus, so fellow students and professors can remember her.